Hi, my name is Carmel. This is my channel, Carmel Codes. I make coding tutorials, and today we're going to learn about Debounce, which is building off of the simple search bar that I built last time. If you haven't seen this video, I'll include a link in the bottom right-hand corner of this video because we do build off of it. So last time, I made this very simple search bar where every single time I type a letter, it finds a match in the list of items, but it is very inefficient. I'm going to add a console.log here that goes in get filtered items. And as you can see, every single time I type a letter, it's this number is just increasing so much. When we don't need to do that, we can do something called debounce, which is when you wait a little bit until the person is done typing, in this case, you, and then you can call get filtered items or make your API call or whatever. It seems like the most straightforward way to do this is with Lodash's library and just taking what they've done with debounce already. And how you can do this is by, if you're in a code pen, doing lodash.debounce, or if you're doing this locally, you can do npm I lodash.debounce. So I went ahead and edit that library here, and I'm going to put it below my other library imports, but above my local imports up here. And I do import debounce from lodash.debounce. Cool. So now that I have this debounce function that Lodash has implemented for us, what I'm going to do is optimize this function down here so that it gets called less and less, because what this set query is doing is it's updating query, which is then triggering get filtered items because query changed, and React just kind of magically knows how to do that. Okay, so enough talking, let's keep coding. I'm going to do const update query is equal to E. This is a function, set query. And I'm going to use optional chaining this time, where I do e.target.value. That's what these little question marks mean. It's basically so that you don't have to do like e.target and e.target.value. You can just do e.target.value. Okay, let me make sure I don't confuse myself. Okay, cool. So we're over here, and we have our new update query function, which is the same as this one. And then we go const debounced on change. So this is our optimized debounce function, is equal to debounce. And I'm going to pass in our update query function. And I chose 200 milliseconds, but this can actually be, you know, however milliseconds feels right to you. I just thought that 200 felt right for some reason. It just felt snappy. So I saved my code and I'm going to refresh. And as you can see, I'm typing, but it's waiting to call get filtered items. So it's just going to wait 200 milliseconds until the last time update query was called to call update query, if that makes sense. If you want more information, please see the Lodash documentation where it explains it creates a debounced function that delays invoking func until after wait milliseconds have elapsed since the last time the debounce function was invoked. It also comes with a cancel function that I have not gone over in this video, but it is there in case you want it. And I absolutely recommend this article that's also linked. It's called Debouncing and Throttling Explained Through Examples. For more information about debounce versus throttling, I thought it was a really good read, and it has all these interactive elements that are pretty nice. Anyway, thanks for watching. I hope this was helpful. Please support the channel by subscribing or liking this video or commenting. It really makes a difference, and you have a good one. Bye-bye.